Keej. Cage? I guess I'll go with Keiji. Is a unique game, to say the least. You try to find your way through the levels using your keyboard to control your movement, but not in the way you're thinking of. Your character's position is indicated by one of the letters on the keyboard, and to move from space to space, you have to press the corresponding key of an adjacent space. It might sound easy, but it's surprisingly challenging. Even as someone who types for a living, I found myself constantly pressing the wrong buttons or having to pause for a moment to figure out where the next adjacent key is. Part of this is because of habit. I'm used to moving using a keyboard, but only with the arrow or WASD keys, with one key being bound to each direction. Part of it is because of the layout of the levels, though. It seems like they aren't laid out exactly as a real keyboard is, and sometimes the angles of the spaces on screen don't match up perfectly to the angles on the keyboard, and sometimes this can cause confusion or deadly mistakes. In terms of accessibility, there are three different keyboard layouts available: QWERTY, QWERTZ, and AZERTY. There's also a colorblind mode, which I tried out. As of the recording of this video, the colorblind mode only changes the coloring of the switches. In the default mode, they're red or green, but with colorblind mode on, they change to different shades of gray. However, while most of the game is pretty monochrome, your goal in each level is green, while lasers and other hazards are red, which would make it impossible for many colorblind gamers to tell the difference. I talked to the developer about this, and they were very interested in how to improve. They pointed out that the goal in each level has a consistent shape, not used for anything else, so that even someone who couldn't see the color would be able to identify it, but I'm concerned that that's not quite good enough. In some levels, you need to react quickly to dodge anything colored red, and if you see the level goal out of the corner of your eye or something, and it appears to be the same color, you might not realize where you need to go. The developer has said that they intend to make some changes to improve this, such as making the goal blue instead of green, but if you're a colorblind gamer and you have difficulty with this, get in touch with them. They are interested in improving. Points for caring about accessibility. So how about that gameplay? Each level contains a different challenge. Some of them are puzzles of various types. You have to figure out how to get through doors or around lasers, or what switches to press to open the door to the next level. Usually there's some sort of clue in the level somewhere that nudges you in the right direction. Some of these puzzles are very clever. On the other hand, some levels are purely reflex-based. You have to respond to prompts very quickly, or navigate the level fast and without error while being chased by an enemy. Some levels combine both puzzles and reflexes. Each level is unique, and I thought most of the design was quite good, even if my reflexes weren't quite up to the challenge sometimes. So is it fun? Well, it depends on what type of gaming you enjoy. If you love really challenging games that require you to learn and practice new skills, you might really like this one. It's very challenging. There are no difficulty settings, and I was only able to get through some of the levels using hints and shared solutions from the discussion boards. In the end, I didn't finish the game. Personally, I couldn't quite get used to the controls, and while I enjoyed many of the puzzles, the precision necessary to get through some of the reflex levels just seems beyond me. In other words, it's just too difficult for me. But just because it's not for me doesn't mean it's not worth playing, if it's your type of game. If the idea of trying to learn and master a new, very complex control scheme and then use it to overcome difficult challenges sounds appealing to you, you might really enjoy Keiji. If you're interested in giving the game a try, it's available on Steam. Check the link in the description. And if this type of game just isn't for you, don't worry. I'll be back soon with another new indie game, and who knows? That one might just turn out to be your new favorite game. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.